want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Red Goldbacks!
When do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Red Goldbacks!
When do we want it?
Now!
Fight, fight, fight!
Housing is a right! Fight, fight, fight! Housing is a right! Fight, fight, fight! Housing is a right! Fight, fight, fight! Housing is a right! Fight, fight, fight! Housing is a right! Fight, fight, fight! Housing is a right! Fight, fight, fight! Housing is a right!
What do we want?
And I'm here part of the Rent Justice Coalition. This is a citywide coalition. This is a citywide coalition that represents tenants from all over New York City. So I just want to do a quick roll call. Do we have the Bronx in the house? Do we have Queens in the house? Do we have Manhattan? Board is about to meet, and one of the demands, the only demand that we have, is a rent rollback.
That's right.
Enough is enough. This is the time for the tenants to have some relief with this high rent. And we're going to go inside, and that's the only thing that we are demanding, a rent rollback.
Yes.
We have some speakers. And this campaign not only is community organizations, but also our elected officials. And we are together in this fight. And I want to welcome Council Member Ben Kallos, one of the supporters to this campaign.
What do we want?
Rent rollback!
When do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Rent rollback!
When do we want it?
Now!
So I'm Council Member Ben Kallos, and I'm here on behalf of the Progressive Caucus, which voted to take on the Rent Just Coalition as one of our campaigns. Woo! So the Progressive Caucus of the City Council stands with you today. Woo! The Progressive Caucus says it is time for a rent roll back. And just so you know, some of the folks involved, anyone know Jamani Williams, our housing chair? I'm here on his behalf, and if there was anything that could stop him, there is very few things that could stop him, but he wishes he could be here, and he asked that I say a couple of words on his behalf. We are so lucky to have him as our housing chair. We also have council member Helen Rosenthal. We have one of her staffers here today. And part of being part of the Progressive Caucus means we have our Progressive Caucus director, Alana Cantillo, who is joining our fight. But now you have 16 or 17 council members here with you today. Last year, we made history with a rent freeze. And guess what? The costs have gone down. Which means it's time to make history once again with the first ever rent rollback. Gave landlords a rent increase even when it outpaced inflation. Even when the inflation was going down, landlords still got increases by as much as 8.5%.
That is right! That is right!
And so we need this rent rollback to start to help bridge that gap between what all the tenants have been paying and what the landlords have been making. Because this year, their costs have gone down. It is time for our first rent rollback and the first of many.
Thank you, Council Member, and thank you to all the elected officials that are here today. We also have tenants from all over the city, and we want to have some of them speak so they can tell you from firsthand what they are going through and why a rent rollback is so important. So please help me welcome Angela Pan from the Met Council. Okay. So we're going to welcome Monica Duke from Tenants and Neighbors. So Monica, please come in.
Monica, come on down.
All right, Monica.
Monica, don't be shy now.
Hello, Monica.
Monica. Yeah.
All right.
My name is Monica Duke, and I'm a member of Tenants and Neighbors. I support strengthening tenants' rights and the preservation of at-risk affordable housing in New York City. I stand with the Rent Justice Coalition, and I strongly agree that the Rent Guidelines Board should consider a rent rollback for all tenants, particularly due to the significant increases over many years preceding last year's freeze. This includes an 8.5% increase for two-year leases in 2009 during the height of the recession, which has caused many members of my community and tenants in my building to remain teetering on the edge of losing their homes due to unreasonably high rents. Within the last year, 40% of the tenants in my building have lost their rent-stabilized leases.
That ain't right!
That ain't right!
And I'm at risk of losing my own.
That ain't right!
That ain't right!
It is frightening. It is frightening to know that in 2015, in one of the wealthiest cities in the world, more than 50,000 people slept in homeless shelters. There were over 200,000 evictions and possessions, and it is estimated at 43% of all evictions came from rent-stabilized apartments.
They're right! They're right!
This should not be happening in this city, and New York City Rent Guideline Board needs to freeze rents for all rent-stabilized tenants this year.
Thank you. That's right!
Area, I want to invite Rigoberto Silva to please come in.
Vamos, Rigo!
Buenas tardes con todos.
Buenas tardes.
Mi nombre es Rigoberto Silva. Y soy miembro de Se Hace Camino a Nueva York. Ok, yo soy inquilino y vivo en un apartamento en Queens, en el 3522 de la 92 en Jackson Heights. En ese apartamento tengo 2 años y rento y pago una renta de $2,000. Compartimos el apartamento entre varias personas y por circunstancia de la vida, mi trabajo no está muy bueno y tengo que vérmela a veces para pagar la renta. Ahora mismo estoy recibiendo desempleo, a pesar de que yo tengo muchas licencias de trabajo, porque yo tengo mi licencia de trabajo en asbesto, en mojo, tengo licencia de scaffold, pero el trabajo está duro ahorita. No tengo trabajo, entonces estoy cogiendo employment, estoy cogiendo desempleo. Y muchas veces tengo que vérmelas para poder completar el dinero de la renta, porque no me alcanza. Vivir en la ciudad de Nueva York es bien duro, pero como nosotros nos sentimos bien y como quien dice, nos sentimos en nuestra casa, pues nosotros tratamos de sobrevivir aquí.
I'm going to translate real quick. His name is Rigoberto. He's from Queens. He is right now living in an apartment and he's paying about $2,000.
Yeah,
he just had trouble in his house, trouble with his employment, and right now he is struggling just to keep up that rent. He's saying also that this is our city and we all have the right to live in this city.
La industria del real estate está fuerte y hay mucho desplazamiento y la gentrificación está encareciendo la vida y favoreciendo a los propietarios y todas estas razones, por esto pido que se decidan a apoyarnos por una renta justa. Porque la necesitamos, porque Nueva York es nuestra casa.
Aquí estamos
y aquí nos quedamos. ¡Se puede!
¡Sí se puede!
¡Se puede!
¡Sí se puede!
¡Se puede!
¡Sí se puede!
We have a tenant from the front that she's going to also share her story with us. So please welcome Lourdes de la Cruz.
Buenas noches, mi nombre es Lourdes de la Cruz y soy líder de casa.
Good evening, my name is Lourdes de la Cruz and I'm a casa leader.
Porque queremos una reducción, nos pasaríamos toda la noche enumerando las razones por las que nosotros queremos una reducción de renta.
We would be here all night if we were listing out all the reasons why we need a rent reduction this year.
Le voy a poner un ejemplo de mi edificio, 2 ejemplos de mi edificio. El primero, hay una inquilina que se cayó y le pidió al casero que le diera un apartamento abajo, más bajo, para ella no tener problemas subiendo y bajando las escaleras, y él le contestó que bajara la cama al lobby.
So a tenant fell and got hurt and asked the landlord to move her to a lower apartment because the elevator is broken, and his response was, bring down your bed to the lobby.
Por ejemplo, mi suegra le amputaron una pierna y pierde muchísimas citas porque no la pueden bajar. Sin embargo, nosotros estamos pagando $1,400 mensuales de renta.
My mother-in-law had a leg amputated and she misses appointments all the time because the elevator is never working and she can't make her appointments. And this is when we're paying $1,400 in rent.
Los casos son muchos. Nosotros como organizadores y como líderes de casa hemos visto muchas cosas. Tenemos edificios que tienen un mes sin gas. Un mes sin gas.
As casa leaders and casa organizers, we see a lot. We have buildings who don't have gas for a whole month without gas.
Lo único que me resta por decirle es que tenemos que mantenernos unidos. Unidos siempre y luchar por nuestros derechos.
And the last thing is to remind ourselves to stay united and to keep fighting because we have no other choice.
The next speaker is a tenant from the Lower East Side, so I want to invite Jacqueline Gallo to come and share her story.
Hi, my name is Jacqueline Gallo. I'm the co-leader of the St. Mark's Tenant Association, representing four buildings with over 75 apartments in the East Village. We have been working with the indispensable tenant advocacy group Goals over the last several months.
Goals.
Let me tell you why landlords absolutely do not deserve a rent increase and why tenants absolutely deserve a rent rollback. Landlords have shown a pattern of abuse toward rent-stabilized tenants. The majority of tenants in our buildings are rent stabilized, and although our rent goes up, 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 the conditions we've been living in have gone down, down, down. My building went over 15 months with no gas. We're only 4 months into 2016. We've had at least 30 days with no heat or hot water. The list of building-wide complaints from tenants include broken front doors, cracked steps, rusted stoops, holes in the walls, dusty halls, leaky roofs, black mold, water leaks, broken radiators, chipped paint, broken windows, My neighbors are the heart of New York City. Many are legendary and beloved artists, actors, writers whose valuable time is spent sitting in the office of Goals every Friday night trying to organize and take action against one of the many profiteering landlords corrupting our community. A landlord who is really an assets company comprised of financiers who have most likely never stepped foot in our building. Asking for more money for less service and deteriorating conditions is a slap in our face. We need a rent rollback.
Yes.
Rollback!
New York City has always been known for its rich diversity, and yet low-income people of color have continued to be displaced year after year, while landlords usher in out-of-state students and Wall Street types for fast profit and high turnover rate to justify more rent increase.
Get it right!
I'm with Wall Street.
Greedy landlords displace people who have lived in and maintained their community for generations so they can make more profit. There were almost 222,000 evictions and possessions in 2015. Almost half came from rent-stabilized apartments. Not coincidentally, in 2015, almost 60,000 homeless people slept in homeless shelters. We believe a significant amount lost their homes to rent-stabilized homes. We have long suffered from profiteering landlords and deserve rent justice.
Yes.
Don't believe me? The data is in. Operating costs for owners, like you said, has gone down 1.2%. Who keeps the profits? Mortgage interest rates are the lowest they've been in decades. Who keeps the profits? Owners have been allowed to increase stabilized rent through major capital improvements, vacancy, eviction bonuses, and individual apartment improvement increases. Who keeps the profits?
It ain't right!
Net operating operating income and rental income for owners has gone up 10 years in a row. The data is in. Landlords will not suffer if tenants receive a rent rollback. While owners continue to collect profit, rent-stabilized tenants and families continue to struggle, paying 35 to 50% of their income toward rent. One out of four tenants pays over 50% of their income toward rent. I can't find the means to justify why we do this other than a love for the city. Those who have contributed and defined this city are now left to the hands of greedy profiteers. Tenants have long suffered from rent increase. In the interest of rent justice, tenants deserve a rent rollback.
Speak for all our voices and the need for a rent rollback, what's fair and just in the city.
Yes.
Yeah.
The landlords, they had a 40% reduction of fuel. All that savings, who sees that? The landlord. Well, we've never seen a rent decrease in 47 years of the Rent Guidelines Board. We've seen the net operating income go up for the owners. We've seen their rent income go up for the owners. We've seen tenant incomes go down. And every year, year after year, we see rent increases, except last year where we got a one-year rent freeze. Yeah. That's all because of all the work you all did, allowed us together to say the data requires us to give a rent freeze. This year, the data's better. This year, the story's better. This year, the facts are with us. 21,000 of our brothers and sisters in New York were evicted last year.
Hey, right!
43% of those people were out of rent-stabilized apartments.
Hey, right!
Today, we need to take a stand and say, we need a rollback. We need to stop the bleeding. We can't live with 58,000 homeless people anymore. We can't live in a city like that.
Hey, right!
So today, we're going to go in there, and we're going to demand a rent rollback.
Yeah.
What do we want?
Rent rollback!
When do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Rent rollback!
When do we want it?
Right.
Yeah.
So what do we want?
Rent rollback.
When do we want and make sure that you have your voice, okay? So we need to be as loud as possible. But before we go in, I want to thank everyone for coming today.
Let's go!
First, I want to acknowledge Sarah from Council Member Helen Rosenthal. Thank you, Sarah. I want to acknowledge Alana from the Progressive Caucus. And I want to acknowledge also Edward Sima from Assemblyman Cabinet. And I want to acknowledge Adele Barlett from the Borough President Gail Brewer. Thank you, everyone. Let's come in.
Jesus Christ! Jesus Christ!